Hey everyone, Jessica Coulter here, and today I have a special treat for you guys. I've got a contractor who is a computer engineer, and he's going to talk to us all about school and the computers you need for school. So this is Adam.
Hey everyone.
So if you are in this position right now, you are trying to figure out what computer you need for school, or maybe your child needs for school, if your school is not providing one for you, well then let us know this message is relevant to you. Tap that like or heart button for us, just to let us know you're there and listening. So before we get into all of that, just want to give you guys a proper introduction in case you're tuning in for the first time. Again, my name's Jessica Coulter, and I'm the CEO and founder of Ace Cookie Tutoring. I work with students in the third grade and beyond, all the way up through adults in grad school, and I have three specialties that are, we got middle school math, the ACT, and proofreading. And like I said, this is Adam, and he doesn't want me to disclose what company he works with. I can completely understand that, but just let me tell you, he's a major computer nerd, geek, whatever you want me to say, and builds computers. He's got this figured out, guys. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to him, and the first thing we're going to talk about for what your computer needs to have if you're to be successful in school, or your child is. And he wants me to make sure this is a recommendation only, but a recommendation of no Chromebooks. So, to you, Adam.
I would personally recommend using a Windows or even a Mac-based computer over a Chromebook, because Chromebooks are really focused on mobile software and the internet. And so, they rely very heavily on Google Docs and other online services. While if you buy either a Windows PC or even a Mac, you'll be able to install more software on the computer itself, including something I think is very important, which is Office software.
All right. So he's giving us a little hint to our next one. But before we jump into that, just want to let you guys know that we will be providing more videos like this, as well as tutorials and educational resources and all sorts of good stuff in my group. It's called Students Aiming for A's. The link's in the description. So would love to have you just click that link and answer a couple questions and you guys will be in. So now we are ready to talk about that second thing Adam hinted at, which is our second recommendation and second need for a school computer, and that is Office Suite, Office software. So on to you.
So Office software is really important for a school computer. The most thing that you're going to be using a computer for in an educational environment, you're going to be writing papers, you're going to be making presentations, you're going to be working on spreadsheets and organizing data, and so you're going to need some sort of an Office suite. Microsoft Office is obviously the go-to choice here, because it's the industry standard, it's the school standard, everyone uses Office format. But there's also some other options. A good open source option would be LibreOffice, which is completely free and can support the Microsoft standards. Or if you absolutely have to, there are the online options like Google Docs, but I would recommend going with something that is installed on your computer, then you're not dependent on having an internet connection or having that service be available. And you can also save your files locally and store them on flash drives and other types of devices.
There we go. So that's two recommendations for you guys. So if Adam's getting a little too tech speaky for you, completely understand. And just drop us a comment with your questions. And again, if this is helping out, that's what we are going for. Just let us know by tapping that like or heart button for me. No matter if you're watching us here on Facebook or YouTube or wherever you might be. So there is one more recommendation for you. And we acknowledge it might seem a little obvious, especially with this whole COVID thing and the whole online learning. But we just want to point it out for anyone that might be new to computers or might be new to the idea of online lessons. So the last and probably most important thing, at least right now, for any student computer to have is a camera of some sort.
Yes, a camera is going to be super important with the focus on online learning and online meetings and online pretty much everything with the COVID situation. Pretty much all laptops and even tablets these days come with some form of webcam built in, as well as a microphone. But this is going to be super important. So you may wish to test this out and make sure the image quality is good. If it doesn't have a camera, if it doesn't have a built-in microphone, I would give that machine a pass and find something else. And then if you do end up choosing a desktop over a laptop, just note that desktops usually don't come with a webcam, so you'll want to buy an external webcam to add to your desktop if you choose to buy one of those.
There we go, guys. So those are our three recommendations for what every school computer needs to have. And again, these are kind of intended for people in this situation right now, getting ready to buy a computer for their child or maybe for yourself. And like I said, I know a lot of schools provide them, but if you're going the homeschooling route, or maybe, you know, your school just doesn't provide them because that's just not possible, then consider the things we just talked about, the office suite, something other than a Chromebook, as well as a camera. So we hope you enjoyed the video, and I'd love to have you in my Facebook group so you can get more tips like these. So just go to that link in the description and join my group so we can, and I can, help you achieve your dreams and take advantage of all opportunities that come your way. So thanks so much, guys. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.